I'm Presley, and welcome to BiteSized Experiments. As always, we're going to show you how to do a cool demonstration you can try yourself at home, and then we'll talk a little bit about the science that makes it work. If that sounds like something you'd like, please click the subscribe button down there to keep up with new experiments and demonstrations when we do them. Let's start with part one, the demonstration. You'll need a hairdryer and a small, lightweight ball of some kind, like a ping pong ball or a ball pit ball like I have here. That's all you'll need, so this one's really easy. Then all I'm going to do is point the hairdryer up and turn it at full blast with the coldest air the hairdryer can blow. Once it's blowing, I'll gently put the ball in the airstream and let the hairdryer hold the ball up in the air. That's pretty cool. It's interesting that the ball just stays on the cushion of air and doesn't fall off, right? Do you think it's perfectly balanced because it's pointing straight up in the air? Maybe, but watch what happens when I lean the hairdryer over and push the ball to the side. That's amazing, right? It's like magic. What's holding it up? You can also scale this one up a little bit and use something bigger, like a leaf blower and beach ball. Check this one out. And that's all there is to the demonstration. Try it out for yourself. It's really cool. Try using balls with different sizes and weights, and even different shaped things like blocks. And let me know in the comments what you learned by trying different things. Now on to part two, the science. There's only really one key concept you need to know for this to make sense. It's called Bernoulli's principle, and it says that a faster moving fluid will have lower pressure than a slower moving fluid. There's a little more to it than that, but really all you need to know is that faster moving means lower pressure in a fluid like a liquid or a gas. We're creating a stream of fast moving air that's holding up the ball. But since it's fast moving air, Bernoulli tells us that it's under lower pressure than the air around it. So the air field looks something like this, with a low pressure in the middle and the higher pressure all around. When the ball is in the middle of the stream, it's surrounded by lower pressure air on all sides. But if the ball starts to move out of the stream, it ends up looking like this, with higher pressure air on one side and lower pressure air on the other. When that happens, the higher pressure air pushes the ball back into the stream and keeps it in the middle. Wherever it tries to fall out of the stream, it gets pushed back in. Even if the stream is tilted and the ball is falling down out of the stream. Pretty cool, huh? As the ball gets farther away from the hairdryer, the stream gets slowed down and the pressure difference is less. So the flow holding it in place is no longer enough to hold it up, and it finally falls out. Now that you know how this works, you can keep an eye out for the effect all around you, and you'll have a better understanding of it next time you see it. If you like this one, we have a lot more for you. So please subscribe and click the little bell to get notifications when a new video comes out. Until then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!